Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React AutoComplete component using the Create React App command. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding list and remote data, and customizing pop-up height and width. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create the app using the Create React App toolchain and use VS Code as the editor, and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I create a new application in command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name MyReactApp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, navigate to the desired location and run this example using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the autocomplete here. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and the styles from the app.css file, and import the material theme styles to apply them to the autocomplete. Then I install the autocomplete package using the command npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React dropdowns. To start using the autocomplete component, I import it from the Syncfusion EJ2 React dropdowns package and include the autocomplete component tag. Then add a few styles to align the autocomplete component. Let me run this application. See, the autocomplete is rendered. And you can notice, no suggestions found when I type a text. Data can be bound to the autocomplete using the datasource property and assign the array of string values, such as badminton, cricket, football, golf, and tennis. Let's see the output now. Look now, when I type a text in the autocomplete, the suggestions are shown based on array data. I can also bind JSON array to the autocomplete. Here I will define a JSON object, naming it as sports data. Then define the object values with two fields, ID and game. I will assign this JSON object to the data source property of autocomplete. While binding the data, I also need to map value field to the autocomplete fields. Then I map the game field to the value field of autocomplete component. See here, autocomplete suggestions are shown from JSON object. To bind remote data, I use Syncfusion Data Manager. I import the data manager from the namespace Syncfusion EJ2 data. Then declare a variable remote data and create an instance of data manager to provide the service endpoint URL using URL property. Here, I assign the remote data link. To make the server understand the request and process the response, need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here I use the Web API adapter and enable the cross-domain option. I assign this variable to the data source property. Then, map the field first name from the remote data to the value field of autocomplete component. Also, add the placeholder property and set its value to first name. Declare another variable, data query, and create an instance of the query to specify the field name to fetch from the remote data. Assign this to the query property in autocomplete. Check now, the autocomplete suggestions are based on the remote data. Finally, let's see how to set custom values in the pop-up height and width. By default, pop-up width adjusts to the autocomplete input element width and height set to 300 pixels. I include pop-up height property and set a custom value. Include pop-up width property and set a custom value. See now, the pop-up height and width have been customized. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion React AutoComplete using the Create React App command. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding list and remote data, and customizing pop-up height and width. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.